The next speaker for this session, we are joined by Honorable Bheem Raskar. He is the convener of Mahila Raj Satta Andolan and the director of Resource and Support Center for Development since 1999. Mahila Raj Satta Andolan mainly works on the capacity building and resource training for elected women representatives, especially from the rural areas of Maharashtra. They have also piloted several projects like this across India, not only giving them chance to get elected, but to give them an opportunity to learn further and work better as elected women representatives is what they aim at. With a master's in social work, diploma in personal management and institutional development organization strengthening course from Management Development Foundation in Netherlands, he has worked with several organizations like SHED, the Shramik Vidyapit, and also consultant to the government of Maharashtra on various fronts. Currently, he is working as an invitee member to the Maharashtra State Election Commission. Marathit apan he mhanto ki savitri jhalya gharo ghari pan jyotibacha shodh jari. Ya ekka dheya vakyani mala vatta anek purushanna ya sagyat samajik chalvali madhe hi samavun ghetlay ani Bheem Raskar sir Maharashtratla ek asa naav ahe ki jya savitricha leki Maharashtra madhe vegvegya tappyanvar kam karat ahet nivadnuka ladun ja ladun pudhe yetat त्यांना पुढे आणखीन काय मदत होऊ शकेल ह्याचा सर्वतोपरी प्रयत्न महिला राजसत्ता आंदोलनाच्या माध्यमातून Bheem Raskar सर आणि त्यांची टीम इथे करत आहेत. मुद्दामून एक पुरुष प्रतिनिधी आपल्या ह्या सगळ्या सेशन मध्ये असावा, कारण महिलांचं सशक्तीकरण हे फक्त महिलांचा विषय नाही अशी मान्यता आमची आहे. त्यामुळे Bheem Raskar सर आज आमच्या सोबत आहेत. सर, वी ओपन दिस फोरम फॉर युअर रिमार्क्स अँड कमेंट्स. थँक्यू.
Thank you, Utkarsha. Actually, I am very impressed with the movement, Jai Hind movement, which is going on. And basically, they are focusing mainly on women's forum also. In the beginning, Durgatai, the way she has given the speak, and first mayor of Sangamner, I salute her. I salute all the speakers. And I think as Utkarsha said here, we want to create more men to speak about women's empowerment. This is very essential. And we are trying, like this campaign for women in governance, we are working there for the last 20 years with village elected women leaders. And we are getting very good experience, excellent experience. We are also learning a lot from them. So thank you so much for inviting me. So I will speak with this thing that there are three myths on which we have to work very hard. First myth is very important that women cannot become leaders. Actually, you can see so many prime ministers, so many people. Actually, Durgatai has also explained it. But when I started counting them, especially about India, also, like Germany, you know, last this corona period also, you have seen so many prime ministers has done so much of good work, and they are from most of them are women leaders. I think it's very important. Just if you count also, like from Angela also, so from Savitri Bai, I was just counting it, Indira Ji, Sarojini Naidu, Mamata Banerjee, Sushma Swaraj, Mayawati, Sashikala Kakodkar, Suchita Krupalani, Anandi Ben, Rabri Devi, Mukti Mehboob, Kamala Bashin, Medha Patkar, Gail, so many, Jai Lalita. I think it's very important to understand that women are leaders in several areas, and especially in politics also. So in politics, if so many women members are working, why are we propagating that women cannot become leaders? I think this is the first myth which we have to fight it out clearly. And men are doing best work. They are best leaders in politics also, even in economic field, social field. That is the first thing which I want to express here. Secondly, another myth is there that men are only breadwinners. I think this myth is also need to be clarified clearly in social field, economically. I think there were so many women now, they were richest women in the world. I think globally, we have to think of this, that this myth, we need to clarify that women are also breadwinners, and they are actually supporting family, supporting economy, supporting the nation. Supporting GDP, and I think this myth is there. Women cannot become leaders. Second myth is women, men only, they are the breadwinners. And third myth is especially about India with regard to women's empowerment. In last 70 years, nothing has happened. I think these are the myths which we need to clarify in our society, especially with regard to India. So how to do that? Because there are some issues. There are some challenges which we are fighting with. And I think those issues are there, but they are changing. So first thing which I feel that there are a number of stereotypes which we have to understand those stereotypes. For example, we are working with now, we have reservation, but there are dropout in local self-governance. This is because of stereotypes which are there. Secondly, there are gender protocols in school, colleges, marriages. I think these protocols also we need to understand why these protocols are there, from where it has come. Thirdly, there are still unequal relationship between men and women from birth to date. We need to analyze this properly. Then leadership, I think it's very important that if leadership is there from the family, I think this leadership we need to nurture. Fourthly, power sharing from local self-governance to Lok Sabha. Why men are not interested, political parties are not interested in sharing these powers. And basically, men minds, we need to work with men minds very seriously. Otherwise, always we are working with women and trying to tell them that we should change, who are really empowered, who are really changed. So that is one thing which I want to express here, that there is a big change. There is a process of affirmative actions with regard to women's empowerment. But still, these are the things, these are the myths on which we have to work very seriously. And basically, it's very important that equal justice, without violence, they should be able to go for the leadership. That is one thing which I think Martin Luther King has said, that injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. I think this is very important, that whatever happening, any violence in Pakistan, or if something is happening in Afghanistan or UP or Dombivli, I think these injustices are very harmful for people who are working with. I think for women also it is very important that because of violence, they are not able to empower themselves. And I'm witnessing myself that they are changing, game-changing contribution they are giving. All women, actually, with regard to India, I feel since beginning, first thing which has happened is SHG movement. This Bachat Gat Chalwal, Jizhali. If you go to any village, you will find temples, masjids, and SHG movement. You go to any village in India. I think that is very important, that Kerala's Kutumbashree movement, neighborhood groups, or here we are having Mavim, we are working with MSRLM Livelihood Mission. They have community resource persons. So many women are working and they have come out of the house because of SHG movement. That is the first thing. We had one slogan that from Bachat Satta to Raj Satta, that all these women should come out of the place and they should lead the panchayats, and they are leading it very successfully. Second is 73rd and 74th amendment. Actually, women are working very seriously. Where now I am working for the last 20 years, and I am really enjoying it because you can see some of the changes. Like at policy level also, in the beginning, we had asked for, like we have Gram Sabha. So women ask specially for Women Sabha. This Women Sabha is taking place in 22 states now in Maharashtra, India, and it has started from Maharashtra, from Mahilara Saptandal. Second one is 50% reservation. In 17 states, this 50% reservation in local self-governance is there. So it means lakhs and lakhs of women, they are coming into local governance. We need to facilitate them. And this is a very strong point where we can see that women are leading their villages, women are leading their tehsil places, they are leading Jilla Parishad, and even up to Lok Sabha. I think it's very important to be able to work on this. Even now, they are claiming on their property rights through these political rights. And I think, like, we have the joint house ownership. Now we are going for joint property ownership. So this is very important that all these women leaders, they are forming their associations, federations, and asking for their rights, and not only rights of women, but they are asking for rights of poor people. I think always I have seen that poor first is the theme, is the principle which they are following in their own panchayats. In Corona period, actually, I have observed that there is a local army of women leaders who are working at village level. I don't want to discuss about what other people have done, but at local level, at village level, at community level, I can see that this local army has taken, served the people like anything. And who are those? Basically, Anganwadi workers, Asha workers, these local women leaders, Gram Sevika, secretaries, police patils, CMRCs. I think all these women leaders are like, in each village, you can find women leaders, like, you know, 10 to 12 women who are working there. I think we need to salute them because they have worked day and night against this corona pandemic. I think this is third thing which I observe, which is there. And thirdly, the change which I see, the change makers which I see, is we have institutionalized many things which are supporting women leaders, even women for women empowerment. And that is first thing, like we have women's policy. Actually, we'll be having tomorrow meeting about this, the fourth women's policy we are going to frame. And at national level also, we are going to frame some principles and values under which this country will work, especially for women's empowerment. Secondly, we have women's commission in every state. We have United Nations working for women. We have Commonwealth local government forums with whom we are working for women's empowerment. I think it's very important that even party women's wing, they have secondary status, but they are also working very hard and they are progressing slowly. That all the party, they have women's wings. And you can see that number of, like, a girl is born, Ulgi Zali Ho drama. So many, actually, these poems, stories are there in Maharashtra, in India, which are helping for this women's empowerment. I think these are the things which we need to keep in mind, that wherever we are, we need to check it, and then we can go further for women's empowerment. Because when I went to one of the villages, when I asked there, that why do you need women's empowerment? And one lady of 78 years, she told me, if you are boiling a milk, can you boil a half milk and you will leave half milk just like that? I think this is very basic thought, basic wisdom, which is there, because for any nation development, this 50% women who are there, and I feel from my point of view that they are more capable, they can put a lot of energy in nation building. So it's very important, as that lady from that village said, that half of the milk you can boil, but half of the milk you are just living like that. I think this will not do. This is not correct. So I will say that I have four things which we have to go for. One is, in planning, bottom-up approach is very essential. From SHG to power, from SHG to Lok Sabha, I think this bottom-up approach is missing. We need to go for it. Like power mapping, I see everywhere there is a power. And that's why this power mapping is very essential, where women leaders can go there. From village to country, there are a number of power centers. We have to map it. Secondly, in implementation, program to policy is very important. I think we organize a number of events, but we need to give all the things which we are learning, and we need to put it into policy so that more changes will be there. And at national level, we can do some basic things. Thirdly, in participation also, I think from membership to ownership, this process is very essential. And that's why, because we are trying to see that, like, first you become the member, then you become the volunteer. As one of our speakers said, that she became the volunteer and she found she found that there are a number of good people working in politics. So politics is not bad. It's very important that you love politics, then you will find some change that is there. So membership, volunteership, cadership, leadership, then partnership, and then ownership. I think this whole process of empowerment is very important. And last one is audience to advocacy approach. I think when one woman is coming for the program, I think slowly she should become the advocate for women's empowerment. How to do that? Actually, I can speak a lot about it, but it's very important that in social, economic, political, cultural, and basically, I feel that her role in governance is very important. She should be able to make her laws. She should be able to make her policies on her own, so that whole country, whole nation, even human being, as she said, human rights and human rights, there is no difference. I fully agree with that. So it's very important. I will sum up my whole speech in one poem. I like poems, and poems are very useful for this women's empowerment process. So poem, name of poem is Oth Hamara Raj Hamara. This is in Hindi. चमकदार आंखें हैं लेकिन सारी बातें पढ़ नहीं पाती, फिर संविधान पढ़ना क्यों न सीखे। मजबूत हाथ है लेकिन सारी बातें लिख नहीं पाते, फिर नीति लिखना क्यों न सीखे। चुस्त बुद्धि है लेकिन सारे हिसाब नहीं जानती, फिर हकों का हिसाब मांगना क्यों न सीखे। वोट हमारा है लेकिन राज हमारा नहीं, फिर राज करना क्यों न सीखे। वोट हमारा राज हमारा। थैंक यू उत्कर्ष एंड होल जय हिंद टू आवर टीम। आई थिंक वी विल बी वेरी हैप्पी टू जॉइन विथ यू व्हेरेवर पॉसिबल, बिकॉज वन मूवमेंट, वन महिला राजसत्ता आंदोलन कैनॉट गो फॉर द वुमेन्स एम्पावरमेंट और फॉर एनी चेंज। विल बी वेरी हैप्पी टू जॉइन विथ यू व्हेरेवर पॉसिबल। थैंक्स अ लॉट। थैंक यू
सो मच सर। कोणाची परवानगी न घेता मी आताच तुम्हाला संगमनेरला येऊन आमच्या ह्या इनिशिएटिव्हवर जॉईन होण्याचं निमंत्रण देत आहे सर, कारण तुम्ही ज्या पद्धतीने मांडणी केली अतिशय, म्हणजे मी तर तुमच्यावर काम केलंच आहे, पण इट इज इम्पॉर्टंट की अभ्यासपूर्वक आणि तुमचा जो अनुभव तुम्ही इथे मांडत आहात त्याच्यातले काही मुद्दे, कारण तुम्ही इंग्लिशमध्ये बोललात सर, मी थोडंसं इथे आमच्या महिलांसाठी विशेषतः मांडू इच्छिते। ज्या तीन दंतकथा किंवा अंधश्रद्धा आपण म्हणू, मीच तुम्ही जे वापरले शब्द, की पहिली म्हणजे महिला नेता बनू शकत नाहीत, ही एक अंधश्रद्धा आहे आणि त्याचं उदाहरण म्हणजे दुर्गाताई इथे साक्षात आपल्या सोबत आहेत। दुसरी एक जी तुम्ही मांडली की पुरुष हाच फक्त घरचा करता असू शकतो, तर आमच्या सोबत इथे जयश्रीताई थोरात आहेत ज्या स्वतः एक डॉक्टर आहेत आणि खूप चांगल्या कमवता आहेत। आणि तिसरं जे आपण बोलत आहात की मागच्या 60-70 वर्षामध्ये काहीच झालं नाही, आता हे ऐकून ऐकून तर मला वाटतं बऱ्याच लोकांचा बांध आता फुटायला आलाय। सो हे महत्वाचे मुद्दे सरांनी मांडले की ह्या ज्या दंतकथा किंवा मिथ आहेत हे तोडण्याची आपल्याला गरज आहे, आणि त्यासाठी महिलांबरोबर तर काम करण्याची गरज आहेच, पण पुरुषांसोबतही तेवढ्याच ताकदीने काम करण्याची गरज आहे। एक खूप महत्वाचा मुद्दा जो सरांनी इथे मांडला की बचत गटाची जी चळवळ महाराष्ट्रात नाही तर भारतात खूप मोठ्या प्रमाणात रुजवली गेली, त्याच्यामध्ये प्रत्येक गावामध्ये बचत गट तुम्हाला सापडतील, म्हणजे मंदिर मस्जिद आणि बचत गट हे प्रत्येक गावामध्ये आहेत, असा हा भारताचा एक आपला इतिहास राहिला आहे किंवा अजूनही ती परिस्थिती आहे, त्याचा पुरेपूर उपयोग करण्याची आपल्याला गरज आहे। आणि त्याचबरोबर महिलांनी फ्रंटलाईन वर्कर्स असो किंवा नसो, करोना काळामध्ये जो एक लढा आपल्या समाजासाठी दिला तोही खूप महत्वाचा आहे असं सर इथे प्रामुख्याने म्हणत आहेत। सर वी आर व्हेरी व्हेरी थँकफुल टू यू फॉर थ्रोईंग लाईट ऑन व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट इश्यूज विच वर आवर कन्सर्न्स दॅट नीड टू बी डिस्कस्ड ऍट दिस ग्लोबल फोरम, अँड वी लुक फॉरवर्ड सर फॉर युअर गायडन्स अँड फॉर यू टू कम अँड वर्क विथ अस ऍट द जय हिंद पीपल्स मुव्हमेंट, अँड थँक यू वन्स अगेन फॉर जॉईनिंग अस ऍट दिस स्टेज सर। थँक यू
Thank you.